7:30. جزاك الله خير. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. الله أكبر كبيرا، والحمد لله كثيرا، وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا. الله أكبر، ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. لا إله إلا الله وحده، لا إله إلا الله وحده، صدق وعده ونصر عبده وهزم الأحزاب وحده. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر، الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. الله أكبر كبيرا، والحمد لله كثيرا، وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا. لا إله إلا الله وحده، صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده. لا إله إلا الله، ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا ولا إله إلا الله وصلى الله على سيدنا
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وعشيا. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا. الله أكبر ولا نعبد إلا الله مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وهزم الأحزاب وحده. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله الله أكبر ولله الحمد.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. والله أكبر. الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد.
السلام عليكم. السلام عليكم brothers. Please put your zakat al-fitr before you start the salat brothers. Please put your zakat al-fitr before salat.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Brother, back there, we have a lot of room downstairs in the parking lot. So if you can find the space at the back, please go downstairs. On the first parking lot, we have 15 rows available downstairs. So please go downstairs. The steak is here. Give me 2 minutes. Mohammed. Brother, sisters, on behalf of board of director, all volunteers and council member, we would like to wish you a happy Eid Mubarak. We also want to thank our two Sheikh Hassan, Brother Sheikh Hassan Sayyid and Brother Abdul Karim Hazmi for completing Ramzan. Jazakallah khair both Sheikh. We have a street cleaning today from 8 o'clock to 11 o'clock. But Alhamdulillah, we got approval from the city. So if you get the citation that the first street is a Huron, next one is Tilden, and after that is Harter and Little Culver Boulevard. Out of these four streets, if you have parked your car, if you get the citation, please bring it us. Do not pay your citation. Inshallah, I will cancel your citation. Also today, we will have a Zuma prayer because there's quite a few phone call came in and people are asking. But Zuma will be at same time at 1 o'clock khutbah and 1:30 inshallah will start the prayer. We also have a picnic right after Zuma at the Tellefson Park across the street of the King Fahd Masjid. Inshallah we can stand up everybody and then your heel should be on the blue line.
Brothers, please move forward. We have a lot of brothers waiting outside. Please move forward.
استووا اعتدلوا أقيموا صفوفكم سدوا الخلل. الله أكبر. 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 الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. 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 الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. هل أتاك حديث الغاشية وجوه يومئذ خاشعة عاملة ناصبة تصلى نارا حامية تسقى من عين آنية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارق مصفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله تفرد بالربوبية وأبان للإنسانية دلائل الألوهية. أحمده تعالى وأشكره على ما أسدى من منة وعطية ودفع من نقمة وبلية. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له أنقذنا بالبعثة المحمدية من براثن الإشراك والوثنية، وأعزنا بالتوحيد وأبطل مسالك الجاهلية. وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله خير البرية وسيد البشرية، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه الذين أشادوا صروح الحنيفية وأعلوا منار الملة المصطفوية، والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد، واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. My dear brothers and sisters, it is my honor and it is my privilege to congratulate you today on this blessed occasion of Eid al-Fitr al-Mubarak. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it a day of honor. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it a day of happiness. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it a day of prosperity for us and our Muslim brothers and sisters around the world. On this day of Eid, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the month of Ramadan. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for allowing us to fast and to pray and to recite the Quran and to give sadaqah and to draw closer to Him with other acts of obedience during the great month that passed. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept it from us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our shortcomings and deficiencies. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to witness many more Ramadans to come in the future while we are in a state of iman and health and prosperity. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala today for His blessings upon us. And if we were to try to count the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us, we would never be able to do so. Nevertheless, We strive to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as much as possible to the best of our ability. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised us, He has said, لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِن كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in this ayah that if we are thankful to Him, He will give us more. But if we are ungrateful, then surely His punishment is severe. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among His thankful servants. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from being ungrateful to Him. From thankfulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to look at our situations and compare it with the situation of some of our Muslim brothers and sisters on other parts of the globe. We fasted during the month of Ramadan, but at the time of iftar, we had hot food to satisfy our hunger, and we had cold drinks to quench our thirst. But if we look at the situation of some of our Muslim brothers and sisters in other parts of the world, we find that perhaps at the time of iftar, they cannot even find a date to break their fast. Perhaps they started their fast every morning without even having suhoor, not because they were not hungry, but because it was unavailable to them. When we look at their situation, we must feel their pain, and we must feel compassion towards them. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, مثل المؤمنين في توادهم وتراحمهم وتعاطفهم مثل الجسد إذا اشتكى منه عضو تداعى له سائر الجسد بالسهر والحمى. The likeness of the believers in their mutual love and mercy and compassion towards each other is like one body. If one part of the body suffers, the whole body feels fatigue and fever. This should be our situation. We should feel for them. And we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His blessings upon us. Yet we don't forget them in our prayers, and we support them in any way we can. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant them ease after hardship and relief after distress. Ameen. When we look at the situation of our Muslim brothers and sisters around the globe, it is something that we feel sad about. But at the same time, we need to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the numerous blessings that He has given us. He has given us health, He has given us wealth, and He has given us countless other blessings that if we were to try to enumerate, we would be unable to do so. And from the thankfulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to use His blessings in a way that is pleasing to Him. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us a gift, one of the forms of thankfulness to Him is to use that blessing in a way that pleases Him. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us a blessing, yet we use that blessing to disobey Him, then this is something that is very shameful. And we should think about this anytime the shaitan comes to us and tries to tempt us to commit any type of sin. We cannot commit any type of disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except that we use one of His blessings to commit it. If you look at something haram, you are using the blessing of sight that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you to disobey Him. If you listen to something haram, you are using the gift of hearing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you to disobey Him. And so forth, it goes for every single sin you can commit. There is no sin that you can commit except that you use a blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to commit it. If we think like this, before we embark on any type of disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we should feel ashamed and shy before our Creator to disobey Him. And after the month of Ramadan, we are in a sense of heightened taqwa. Because when we fast for 29 days or 30 days, this is a developer of taqwa. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامِ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. O you who believe, fasting has been prescribed upon you as it was prescribed upon those before you, so that you may attain taqwa. So this month of Ramadan should have been an exercise in the cultivation of taqwa. And we should have that heightened sense of taqwa now that the month of Ramadan is over. So while we are still in this state, do not let it subside. Continue on acts of obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep your taqwa at a high level with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one of the signs of acceptance of a good deed is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives a person the ability to continue upon goodness after the good deed is over. So one of the signs for the acceptance of Ramadan, and of course only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows which of our deeds are accepted, and we ask Him to accept all of our good deeds even though we have shortcomings and we are so deficient. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala out of His mercy to accept our good deeds. One of the signs of the acceptance of a good deed is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows you to do more good after the good deed is over. So one of the signs that your Ramadan has been accepted inshallah is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you the ability to continue upon goodness after Ramadan is over. Continue upon prayer, continue upon sadaqah, continue upon recitation of the Quran. Continue upon all acts of obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is a sign inshallah that your Ramadan has been accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. On the other hand, one of the signs of a rejection of an act by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that He lets the person fall into evil after goodness. So if a person obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during the month of Ramadan, but once Shawwal came, he reverted back to his old ways and returned to evil and abandoned good. This is a sign, wal-iyadhu billah, that perhaps his Ramadan was not accepted from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from this. So keep this in mind. If you want your Ramadan to be accepted, then keep this in mind. And try to continue upon goodness. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you do that after Ramadan is over. We don't want to be among the people who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only in Ramadan and then forget Him throughout the rest of the year. Some of the scholars of the past used to say, بِئْسَ الْقَوْمِ الَّذِينَ لَا يَعْرِفُونَ اللَّهَ إِلَّا فِي رَمَضَانِ. The worst of the people are those who only know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during the month of Ramadan. Their obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes in with the hilal of Ramadan and it leaves with the hilal of Eid. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from this and allow us to continue upon the path of goodness throughout the rest of the year and throughout our lives. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this easy upon us. This is the day of Eid. It is a day of happiness for the Muslims. But sometimes some situations occur that cloud this feeling of happiness a little bit. And what happened yesterday, I'm sure you're all aware of, the shooting that happened yesterday. This is something that causes worry and distress to us. And we condemn in the strongest possible terms what happened yesterday. It has nothing to do with Islam. And Islam is free from the act of criminals. Nevertheless, as Muslims, we may feel the effect of what happened. There may be some people who are ignorant about Islam who may try to blame what happened yesterday on the Muslim community as a whole. And we have had experience with this before, especially after 9/11. Whenever any Muslim commits a criminal act, there are some ignorant people, and I'm not going to say everybody does this, but there are some of the ignorant people who don't know about what Islam really is, and they will try to blame the action of a few oddballs, a few lunatics, on the Muslim community in general. And this is something that is not right. But how should we respond if this type of a situation occurs to us? If somebody tries to insult us, or somebody tries to blame what happened on us, how should we react? We should react in a good way. We should react with kindness and compassion. And we should act with wisdom and with good words. One of the best forms of da'wah to non-Muslims is to show the true character of a Muslim. Show the true example of what Islam really is by your actions. And this is one of the most effective ways of showing the people the true nature of Islam. People living in this country don't have the right image of Islam. They see what they see in the media and they believe it. But if they were to deal with the Muslims in reality, if they were to come to the masjid to talk to the Muslims and get to know them, then they would see that Islam is something different than what they thought they knew. And it is our responsibility to convey the correct message to them. Even if they treat us in a bad way, even if they are mean to us, even if they insult us, even if they offend us, it is our responsibility to show the beauty of Islam in the correct way. And this is not only the responsibility of imams and sheikhs and scholars. No, it is the responsibility of each and every Muslim. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to do this in a beautiful way. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us for all our shortcomings. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to erase our sins. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this a day of happiness for us and Muslims around the world. Ameen. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Walillahi alhamd. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-azim. ونفعني وإياكم بهدي سيد المرسلين. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله العظيم الجليل لي ولكم ولكافة المسلمين من كل ذنب، فاستغفروه وتوبوا إليه، فيا بشرى للتائبين والمستغفرين. إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، هو الأول وعليه المعول، وهو المرتجى، ومنه المبتدى، وإليه المنتهى. وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله، هادي البرية ومعلم البشرية، ومجدد الحنيفية، ومزعزع كيان الوثنية، صلى الله عليه وعلى آل بيته الأطهار، وصحابته الأبرار، وتابعيه الأخيار، صلوات تامات كاملات متعاقبات ما تعاقب الليل والنهار، وسلم تسليما كثيرا. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. الله أكبر كبيرا، والحمد لله كثيرا، وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, the day of Eid is a day of reconciliation. We look amongst ourselves today and we see the situation that the Muslim Ummah as a whole should strive to attain. We see people sitting next to each other of all colors. We see white and black and every color in between. We see people of all different languages. We see people of all different cultures. We see people of all different races. We see people of all different nationalities, all united together under La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. This is the situation that the Muslim Ummah should strive to attain as a whole. And individually, we should try to attain a state of reconciliation between the brothers that we know and between the members of our family. If we are part of a family, and there are many Muslim families that one member doesn't speak to another member. A father is not speaking to his son. A nephew is not speaking to his uncle. A niece is not speaking to her aunt. We see these type of situations based on trivial matters and petty issues. We see the breaking of ties and the severing of relationships. This is something that should not be done. And the day of Eid is a perfect opportunity to remedy this situation. It is a day of forgiveness. It is a day of repairing broken relationships. It is a day of mending fences. So if you have your brother or your friend or a family member whom you have some type of a problem or a dispute with, go ahead and give him a call today. Talk to him. Resolve the issue. Parents who are not talking to their children, resolve the issue. Children who are not talking to their parents, give them a call, apologize, resolve the issue. This is the perfect opportunity, the perfect time to do this. And the people on the day of Eid are happy and they are willing to accept it. If you're afraid they're not going to accept it, inshallah today, they will accept it. You just need to take that first step. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unite our hearts and take away any hatred and enmity we have for each other in our hearts, so that we may be successful with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this day a day of happiness for us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala relieve the distress of Muslims all around the world. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us good in this life and good in the hereafter. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from the fire of Jahannam. Ameen. هذا وصلوا وسلموا رحمكم الله على الرسول المجتبى والنبي المصطفى كما أمركم بذلك ربكم جل وعلا. فقال عز من قائل: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا وحبيبنا وقدوتنا محمد ابن عبد الله. اللهم صل عليه ما تعاقب الليل والنهار، وصل عليه ما ذكره الذاكرون الأبرار. اللهم صل عليه ما زهرت النجوم، اللهم صل عليه ما تلاحمت الغيوم، اللهم صل عليه ما أشرق الضياء ولاح، وصل عليه ما تعاقب المساء والصباح. فصلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وعلى أزواجه أمهات المؤمنين. وارض اللهم عن خلفائه الراشدين أبي بكر الصديق وعمر الفاروق وعثمان ذي النورين وعلي أبي السبطين، وعن العمين الكريمين والسبطين العلمين، وعن الستة الباقين من العشرة المفضلين، وعن أهل بدر والعقبة، وعن سائر الصحابة أجمعين، وعن التابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وعنا معهم برحمتك وكرمك وجودك يا أرحم الراحمين ويا أكرم الأكرمين ويا أجود الأجودين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، وأذل الشرك والمشركين، ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين. اللهم فرج هم المهمومين من المسلمين، ونفس كرب المكروبين، واقض الدين عن المدينين، واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله العظيم الجليل يذكركم، واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم، ولذكر الله أكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد.